In this video, you'll see typical overhead and underground applications of the chance auto-ranging voltage indicator and phasing testers, both analog and digital. Beginning with the full-range auto-ranging voltage indicator, referred to as the RV for short, start by pre-checking it for operable condition using the voltage indicator tester specified in the RV instruction manual. First, connect the alligator clip onto the RV hooks. Then, insert the probe into the back of the RV housing. This pre-check must be performed before each use. Press and hold the power button for 2 seconds. This will initiate an internal self-test. Notice how the RV sequences through a series of all display ranges, verifying it is in operable condition. After the self-test, the power LED continues to flash, indicating the RV is ready for use. Mounted on a universal hot stick of appropriate length for the voltage being worked, turn on the RV and touch its hook to each conductor. Notice that when the RV senses the electric field, it emits an audible beeping sound and displays the appropriate voltage class for the circuit, in this case, 4 kV. Had the circuit been de-energized, no LED for a voltage class would be blinking. After each use, verify the RV is fully functional, again using the voltage indicator tester specified in the instructions provided with the RV. The RV can also be used on underground circuits. Here's how it works to check for voltage at a 200 amp load break elbow with a capacitance test point. The cap covering the test point is removed using an insulated hot stick. Then, with the RV, mounted on a universal hot stick of appropriate length for the voltage, and having replaced the shepherd hook on the front of the RV with a straight test probe, simply contact the elbow test point. Notice that the LED mark TP for test point blinks and the RV beeps, indicating the presence of voltage. After each use, verify the RV is fully functional using the voltage indicator tester specified in the instructions provided with the RV. The RV can also check for potential on an underground cable between transformers or switchgear. Here, notice that a 200 amp load break elbow already has been pulled and parked on a feed-through bushing, and the primary bushing has been covered, all with hot sticks. For this use, the RV has been fitted with a bushing adapter on the front. Simply insert the probe with the adapter into the feed-through bushing. Notice that only the power LED is blinking and none for any voltage class, indicating that there is no voltage present, that the circuit has been de-energized. Now, turning to the chance analog phasing tester, first in a typical overhead application. Start by pre-checking the meter for operable condition using the phasing meter tester specified in the instruction manual. First, connect the alligator clip onto the hooks, then insert the probe into the meter jack. This pre-check must be performed before each use. Flip on the polarity switch. Notice that the needle deflected approximately 3/4 of the meter scale when checking both sticks. Install phasing tester on appropriate length universal sticks for the voltage to be worked. To determine phase relationships on system voltages up to 345 kV, each operator places a hook on the selected conductor. If the two conductors are in phase, the meter registers near zero. When the two conductors are out of phase, the meter indicates actual voltage potential. After each use, verify the phasing tester is still fully functional. Again, using the voltmeter tester specified in the instructions provided with the phasing tester. For determining phase relationships, the chance digital phasing tester works essentially the same as the analog phasing meter. To pre-check the digital phasing tester for operable condition, use the phasing meter tester specified in the instruction manual. Connect the alligator clip onto the hooks, then insert the probe into the back of the phasing tester housing. This pre-check must be performed before each use. Besides being able to determine phase relationships, the digital phasing tester can check overhead voltage, both phase to ground and phase to phase. Here, it displays the actual potential present on this circuit. Both the digital and analog phasing testers can measure voltage on underground systems. Either of the phasing testers can verify that an underground conductor between transformers is de-energized. Here, notice that a 200 amp load break elbow already has been pulled and parked on a feed-through bushing, and the primary bushing has been covered, all with hot sticks. For this use, the analog phasing tester's reel stick has been fitted with a bushing adapter. Simply insert the probe with the adapter into the feed-through bushing. With the meter stick probe, contact is made with the system ground and the meter is checked for deflection. If there's no voltage present on the cable, the meter reads zero. Now, here's the same procedure using the digital phasing tester. Again, with the bushing adapter fitted on the reel stick, the probe is inserted into the feed-through bushing, and the meter probe is contacted with the system ground. Again, the zero reading indicates there is no voltage present on the cable. After each use, verify the phasing tester is fully functional, again with the voltmeter tester for phasing testers. As listed, the instruction manual provided with each, whether the analog or digital type. Both types of phasing testers can also be used for high pot proof testing and underground cable repair prior to putting it back in service. The cable has been isolated on the other end. Here again, notice that the cable's 200 amp load break elbow already has been pulled and parked on a feed through, all with hot sticks. With a DC high pot adapter on the meter stick and a bushing adapter on the real stick, insert the meter probe into the energized bushing and the other probe into the feed through. Notice that the analog meter deflects only slightly and returns to zero, indicating the DC high pot test fully charged the cable and that it has no faults or grounds. That is, it indicates the cable repair was successful. Causes of other test results are given in the high pot adapter instructions. Now with the digital phasing tester, the same procedure gives the same results. Notice that the digital unit also displays only a slight reading and returns to zero, again indicating the cable repair was successful. The follow-up procedure when high pot testing with either the analog or digital phasing tester is to discharge the cable that was tested, using the tester on the feed through and touching the real probe to the system ground. Finally, as before, either phasing tester must be checked to verify it is still fully functional, again using the voltmeter tester for phasing testers listed in the instruction manual.